must I bring the power source?
Travel across the armature to the starboard side, Captain. I will open a maintenance apps for the volcano cannon.
Protocol suspended. Access authorized.
The apps is below you, Captain.
Orbital spire.
Target acquired.
Firing now. Alarm. Ejecting power core. Shutting down all systems.
Captain, all systems are overloading. Did it work?
Invictus performed admirably, Enoch. The warp gate is closing.
Thank the machine god.
Shutting down all systems.
That's done it, Titus.
But Nemeroth and his demon host still roam free.
Though he is trapped on this world.
And all the more desperate to recover the power source. Let's get it to safety, old friend.
Good news on that front. Lieutenant Mira reports that the Liberation Fleet has entered the system. The Inquisition will surely have sent agents with the fleet, Captain. Perhaps we can return the device to them.
The Inquisition has already failed to stop its exploitation by Chaos. No one must use the device, the Andros, ever again. Contact Lieutenant Mira and have her divert a Valkyrie here to pick us up.
Yes, Captain.
I suppose putting a bolt around through that damnable power source is out of the question.
Too risky. We could open another warp gate, for all we know. Upon our return to McCrag, I will confide it to the Chapter Master and his librarians.
And until then?
My most trusted brother will bring it to our strike cruiser and seal it in the armory. Get this damn thing secured, Sergeant.
As quickly as I can.
What will you be doing while I run this little errand?
There are still thousands of traitors and heretics on this world. I intend to drastically thin their ranks.
Lieutenant Mira's Valkyrie is on its way, Captain.
Excellent. We make for the landing pad. And watch for the Chaos Lord's forces.
Retrieve the warp device.
Sidonus, get to the landing pad.
Aye, Captain. Traitors are determined, and this landing pad does not offer much cover.
What's that grenade?
Kill the old raids! Thank you.
couldn't reach him in time.
Sidonus died as we all should. In righteous battle. Do not give him a grief yet. Turn your thoughts to vengeance. Nemeroth will pay in blood. Shall know no fear!
I couldn't reach him in time.
Sidonus died as we all should. In righteous battle. Do not give in to grief, Leandros. Turn your thoughts to vengeance. Traitor Lord murdered him. Nemeroth killed Sidonus for the power source. You said the Inquisitor's work was heretical, Leandros. You are right.
What do you mean?
Nemeroth plans to use the power source to trigger his transformation into a demon prince.
Abomination!
How can we stand against such a creature?
I will kill Nemeroth when he's most vulnerable. During the transformation. Safeguard Sidonis until the apothecary arrives. Then join the Imperial attack.
Going alone is suicide. Or worse. We know the enemy takes great interest in your connection to Chaos.
Do you fear my falling to Chaos?
Of course not. Whatever lies behind your resistance, it can only be to the enemy's favor.
Why? Perhaps this resistance can get you close enough for a killing blow.
I will destroy Nemroth with skill and steel, or die trying. If this resistance comes into play during battle, so be it.
So be it.
I must reach the orbital spire.
Farewell, Captain.
Permeates this facility, but it is tolerable because it represents progress. I acquired specimens for experimentation. Org, Tau, Eldar. Even a Tyranid Lictor, which nearly caused a revolt among my tech priest allies. I designed the weapon to use the warp energies to target the weak points in the Xenos brain and rupture them. That is the tidy theory. When I put it into practice, however, the specimen's head explodes. Distasteful, but effective. The weapon works.
It may be severed, but it's still the enemy's strong point.
The fleet is preparing an all-out assault.
Yeah!
safe from you, demon.
You will tell me after you're dead.
Really?